Hi friends, today we are going to discuss about the chi-square test or the goodness factor. It is a continuation of the previous class. Okay, so now we are going to discuss this concept. So here, the chi-square test is used to test the differences between the observed frequencies and the expected frequencies are significant. Okay, we are going to observe the differences between the observed frequencies and the expected frequencies, whether they are equal or not. Okay, so for that we are going to use the goodness of the condition. So generally we are going to observe the table values under the following case. So in normal case, n number of series values available. You can see the table value under degrees of freedom n minus 1. When you are going to find the expected frequency here by using binomial distribution, at that time you can see the table value under the degrees of freedom n minus 1. Suppose if you can find the expected frequency by the binomial distribution, at that time you can see the table value under the degrees of freedom n minus 2. So in normal distribution similarly, you can see the table value under degrees of freedom n minus 2. Okay, in this case, test the statistics formula. Summation of OI minus EI equals OI by EI. Where OI is observed frequency, EI is expected frequency. This is test statistics. So then coming to the problem. Okay, the number of automobiles accidents per week in a certain community are as follows. So the values are given. So 12, 8, 22, 14, 10, 15, 6, 9, 4. Okay, are these frequencies in agreement with the belief that accident conditions were the same during the 10 week period? Okay, what is that? So we are going to observe that. Okay, accident conditions were the same during the 10 weeks period. So you can verify the accident conditions are same in that particular 10 weeks period. Okay, coming back. So observed values already there. In each week, the values, observation values are there. 12, 8, 22, 14, 10, 15, 6, 9, 4. But here you have to calculate the expected frequency. Okay, series of n values are given. Series of n values are given. So no chance to find the expected frequency here by using binomial Poisson or normal. So that we can go to find expected frequency by using the normal way. That means sum of the values, sum of the observed values by number of observed values. It is nothing but is a expected frequency in each week. Okay, then go to collecting this sum value. In total sum will be equal to 100, and dividing the number of weeks is equal to 10, then it will be equal to 10. This is the expected frequency in each week. So okay, so I am going to note mentioning the values each week. The first week expected 10, second week 10, like this. Okay, then go to find the differences between the observed values and expected values. So these are the differences. So then go to finding the OI minus EI whole square by EI. So this is the value. So 26.6 is the total value. Okay, now go to test of hypothesis. Okay, coming to first one, H naught is a null hypothesis. What is the null hypothesis? That the action condition was same during the 10 week period. Same. That is, all things in all things they are equal conditions. Then go to take alternative hypothesis. Alternative means opposite of the null hypothesis. What is the opposite? Means not same during the 10 week. The conditions are not same. That is all the hypothesis. Then what next step is? Find the LOS level of significance. Okay, if you find in general, we are going to find the level of significance at 5% level. Under the degrees of freedom, n minus 1. Okay, we are going to expected value. We are finding the expected value by using the normal method. So that in the normal method, the degrees of freedom, okay, n minus 1 to consider. So n minus 1 is 10 minus 1, 9. So under the degrees of freedom 9, at alpha 5%, the table value is 60.9. Okay, once again, we will be reading the degrees of freedom at 9 at alpha 5% is 60.9. The next one is test statistics. What the condition statement is? That chi square is equal to OI minus EI whole square by EI. This total is equal to this one. Okay, 26.6. This is the statistics value. Then conclude them. So, what is the table value? 60.9.
equal value. So that means H naught is rejected. So when you are going to accepting the H naught, under the value, under the table value, then only we are going to find defining H naught is accepted. But in this case, calculator is more than the table value. So that H naught is rejected. What is H naught? Okay, X condition was saved in the 10 weeks period. So this is not correct. So that means, okay, the action condition are not same during the 10 weeks period. Okay, thank you.
Hi friends, today we are going to be discussing about the topic price for test for Boolean survey. In this area, this is the second problem. Okay, the following the distribution of the hourly number of trucks arriving at the company warehouse. So, trucks arriving per hour 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 trucks arriving per hour. Frequency 52, 151, 130, 102, 45, 45, 1, 2. Okay, now coming from fit a Poisson distribution. Fit and using digit a parameter lambda. Lambda means in a Poisson distribution. Lambda is nothing but is a mean of the Poisson distribution. Fit a Poisson distribution test for goodness of it. So in this area, so we are asking you two different type of questions. One is a fit a Poisson distribution. Second one is a test for goodness of it. Okay. Coming to fit a Poisson distribution. Fit a Poisson distribution means, so already observed frequency is already given. So you have to calculate the expected frequency. That means it is a fit of Poisson distribution. So we are going to find first expected frequency. In a Poisson distribution, okay, to find the expected frequency, here the first parameter lambda is recorded. So first you can calculate the lambda value. What's the formula for lambda? Lambda is nothing but is a mean. Okay, lambda is nothing but mean. Mean in a Poisson distribution. Based on the frequency. So these are the hours and these are the frequencies. But you know, giving this type of table, the mean formula is nothing but sum of fi, xi by sum of fi. It is equal to lambda. What is the lambda formula? Sum of fi, xi by sum of fi. This is the formula for the mean. Okay, already there. Okay, now, these are the xi values, these are the fi values. Then multiply and taking sum and dividing by sum of the frequency. It will be equal to 2.02. Okay, then next one is to find the expected frequency. In a Poisson distribution, expected frequency formula f of x is equal to n into p of x. In a Poisson distribution, p of x is nothing but e4 minus lambda, lambda for x by x factor, where lambda is the mean of the Poisson distribution. Okay, now go to find the expected frequency for these values. So after frequency already there, then you have to verify the expected frequency. Okay. So first find the expected frequency for 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, now I am going to find the expected frequency. What is the formula for expected frequency? F of x is equal to n into p of x. In coming to here, okay, first find the expected frequency for 0. So okay, by using this relation, f of x equals 0 equal to n into p of x equal to 0. What is the p of x? By the distribution formula. Equal minus lambda, lambda for x by x factor. Then you have to put n is equal to total frequency. What is the total frequency is given? It is 500. Okay, 500 into e power lambda value. Minus 2.02 into 2.02 whole power 0 by 0 factor. It is equal to 66. Similarly, you can calculate the expected frequency for 1. So expected frequency for 1 equal to n into of x equal to 1. Then apply the condition, then it is getting 134. Similarly for 2. Okay, for 3, for 4, for 5, and 6, 7, 8. Okay, you can calculate the expected frequencies. Okay, for 1, 2, 8 values. Okay, these are the expected frequencies. These are the observed frequencies. Okay, what you are asking? To fit a Poisson distribution means you have to calculate only expected values. So these are the expected values. They are asking two different questions. One is fit a Poisson distribution. Second one is test for goodness of it. The first one is fit a Poisson distribution. That means we have to calculate the expected frequency. Okay, by using the Poisson distribution. In a Poisson distribution, expected frequency is nothing but happening into P of x. P of x is the distribution of the Poisson. Okay, so we have calculated expected frequencies at for 0 to 8 values. Okay, nah? So this is nothing but is a fit of a Poisson distribution. Now go to next one is test for smoothness of it. So what is the meaning of test? That means we are going to observe the differences between the observed frequencies and expected frequencies are significant. What we are going to observe is observed frequencies and expected frequencies. Differences between observed frequencies and expected frequencies are significant. Okay, we are already calculated the expected frequency. Observed frequency already there. Okay, so now observed values are right. These are the observed values. These are the expected values. We have calculated these expected values by the Poisson distribution. Okay, noted. Then taking the differences, okay, OI minus VI, then OI minus VI whole square, taking square root of it. Okay, then again dividing by square value by VI value, then the total value is to 9.32. This is the table. Now what we are going to so test the hypothesis. Okay, put in the H now. Then fit a Poisson distribution. What is that? Test a Poisson distribution. Goodness of it. Become H naught is Poisson distribution is a good fit. H1 is alternate of H0. What is alternate? Not a good. H0 is a good fit, but alternate is not a good fit. Okay, then level of significance. So you can calculate the level of significance at alpha 0.05 under the degrees of freedom. Under the degrees of freedom. Okay, n minus 2 under the degrees of freedom, meaning Poisson distribution. We are going to see the table value under the degrees of freedom. N minus 2. So number of values is given 9. So 9 minus 2 equals 7. Under the 7 degrees of freedom, at the alpha 0.05, the table value is 14.067. Okay, this is the table value. Then go to test statistics. What the form of the statistics? Chi square equals summation of OI minus DI by A. OI minus DI whole square by A. So the value is equal to here to there. So 9.32. Okay, this is the test table value. This is the calculated value. Table value is 14.067. The calculated value is 9.32. Okay, then. Okay, test statistics. Chi square equal to summation of OI minus DI whole square by A is equal to 9.32. So this is the calculated value of the table value. Then conclusion. So what is the calculated value? 9.32. Table value 14.067. So calculated value under the table value. That means H0 is an accepted. What is H0? The Poisson distribution is a good fit. Okay, na? So this is the problem. Observe this one. The calculated value is less than the table value. Okay, accept the H0. Suppose if the calculated value is more than the table value, okay, H0 is a rejected. But in this case, calculated value is less than the table value. So that H0 is accepted. That means Poisson distribution is a good fit. Thank you.